Hello everyone. We are going to see a project online examination for school students. This project is developed in .NET 2012 and front-end in ASP.NET and C# as coding language. To start the application, go to Start, click Visual Studio 2012. To open the project, go to File, click Open and choose Website. Select the project folder and then click Open. Choose the first form of the project from the Solution Explorer and then click Run. So this is the home page of the application. So in this application we have three users: admin, staffs and student. This application will be very helpful to conduct online test. Valuation can be done easily without any human errors and wasting time. So first let me log in as admin. The username for admin is admin and the password is 123. Click login. This is the home page of admin. So the next tab is create subject and the next tab is create staff. So here the admin is allowed to create the subject and to create the staff. Let's see one by one. So clicking on the button create subject, I'm going to create a subject. So here you can see the grids with the details. So these are the details I have created already. So let me add in little more information. So in the first category, group creation, let me create a group. So we have already biology group, commerce group and max group. So I'm going to create a computer science group. So click on save. So this group will be added in the grid. So you can add as many group you want in this category, and then all the group we have created in the last category will be loaded here in the drop down. So I'm going to choose the same computer science which we have created and enter the standard. So we have already few standards. So here I'm going to create 12A and create save. So you can create as many standards you want. So for example, let me create 12B and save. So if you don't want any class, you can simply click on delete and delete the class. So the next tab is subject creation. So here you can create the subject and allot the subject name for each category and for each standard for each group. So I'm going to choose the same computer science, and in the computer science we have two classes, that is 12A and 12B. So that should be loaded here. Yeah, there is only two. So I'm going to choose 12A and the subject name is CS. Let me put CS. So that subject is also computer science. So click save. So now in the computer science for 12th year, there is only one subject, CS. For example, let me choose English. Click save. So for 12th year, there is two subjects, CS and English. And Max for computer science and 12A. Click save. So now I have created three subjects for computer science, English and maths. Now the next tab is create staff. So here I can create the staff. So I already created two staffs here. You can see in this grid, one is Sonal and one is Rock. So let me create one more staff now. So the staff name is Kate. Sorry, I have to give the ID, staff ID. So my staff ID is 012 and the name is Kate. Age, gender and year of experience and the group. So let me select computer science which we created and the phone number, mail ID. And click on the button generate username and password. You will get a username and password. So let me save it in a notepad. So for Kate, and Kate is a staff, let me put staff 1 and the password is this. So click on create staff. Now you can see this, that the Kate information is added to the grid. So if you want to delete any delete the staff, you can simply click on delete, or you can edit the information. So next, question bank. So here you can see all the questions. We'll come back to this page again. The next tab is change password. Admin can change the username, change the password here by giving the old password a new password. So let me click logout and show you as a staff. So we have a username and password now. So staff ID, username and the password. So now click login. So this page is to start the test. We'll come back to this page again. So the next tab is create student. So here the staffs are allowed to create the student. So here you can create as many students you want. So let me create the first student with the ID S003 and the name is, let it be George. Male and the group, so he belongs to computer science group and the section 12th A. Here let me put this year and the phone number, email ID. And click on create username and password so that you will get a username and password for the student ID for George. And then click create student. So now the student is created. So let me quickly create another student also. So the ID is S004. As soon as you enter the roll number here, the system will check for the availability of the roll number. So the gender, same class, computer science and 12th A, same year. And the phone number, email ID, and again click on the generate username and password to generate the username and password for the Bella account and the password. So now click create student. The again this Bella student is created. So the next tab is manage student. Here you can see the student you have created. So I have created only two student in this account. So you can edit the information or you can delete it by clicking on delete button. So the next tab is upload questions. So here the staffs are allowed to upload the question. So I'm going to choose on computer science and the class 12A and the subject, we have three subjects, so I'm going to choose CS. So let me I already collected few questions, so let me copy paste it. So the first question, the question and the options here. So B, C and D. So before saving the question, you should choose which is the right answer. This radio button will allow to choose only one answer. So I'm going to choose A and then click save. Now the question will be inserted in the database. So now the next question. And the D option. So the answer is C. Don't forget to choose the radio button and then click save. So the second question is ready. Third question and the options. So answer for the third question is option B. So choose B and then click save. So the fourth question. This is one time work, so this may take time, but the valuation will be very easy when comparing to correcting the papers. It can avoid the time, wasted time, and it can save the material usage also. So the answer for the fourth question is A. Choose A and then click save.